各位弟兄姐妹，大家平安。
Peace to all brothers and sisters.
愿神的恩惠常常与大家同在。
May the grace of God always be with you.
好，我们看一看彼得后书第一章。
Let's turn to 2 Peter chapter 1.
彼得后书的第一章。
2 Peter chapter 1.
我们来读第十节。
Let's read verse 10.
后书一章十节。
2 Peter chapter 1 verse 10.
所以弟兄们，应当更加殷勤。到这里。
Therefore, brethren, be even more diligent.
第五节。
Verse 5.
因为这缘故，你们要分外的殷勤。
Verse 5. But also for this very reason, giving all diligence.
所以从第三节到第十节，它有一个重要的主题，就是我们要分外的，要更加的来殷勤。
So from verse 3 to verse 10, this passage has a theme of being more diligent and giving all diligence.
我们活在人间啊，我们发觉到有的人很努力在过一生。
So while we're living in this world, we realize that some people are diligently living their lives.
他们在阳光下流着汗水，认真过着每一分钟。
They toil and sweat under the sun and are hardworking for every minute.
有的人呢在浑水摸鱼啊。
But others are just passing away the time.
在冷气房打电动啊，整个晚上不睡觉。
Playing video games and pulling all-nighters in an air-conditioned room.
我们常常说天才是 99% 的努力汗水。
So there is a saying that a genius is 99% perspiration.
我们努力不一定成功。
And even though we are hardworking, we may not succeed.
但是不努力却很难成功。
But if one is not hardworking, then it is really difficult to succeed.
我们在奔跑天国路呢，是彼得长老勉励我们要更加努力，更加殷勤。
So as we are running along this path towards the heavenly kingdom, Elder Peter encourages us to be more diligent.
我们常常听过一句话，就是学习如同逆水行舟，你不听就会退步。
So there is a Chinese saying that learning is like navigating a boat against the current. So if you are not hardworking, then you will be going backwards.
我们灵修也是一样。
And this is true as well for spiritual cultivation.
那所以我们用更加殷勤来学习彼得后书的一章三到十一节。
So we will use this topic of being more diligent to learn from 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 3 to 11.
这里告诉我们三个信息。
Here it tells us three teachings.
为什么我们要更加殷勤呢？
For why we have to be more diligent.
我们要在哪几方面更加殷勤呢？
In what aspects should we be more diligent?
更加殷勤又有什么好处呢？
And what are the benefits for being more diligent?
往往读了彼得后书这一段信息。我们弟兄姐妹不要再偷懒了，大家一起来殷勤灵修。
So hopefully after reading this passage in 2 Peter, brothers and sisters will no longer be lazy, but will be more diligent in spiritual cultivation.
那么我们要更加殷勤呢？
So first, why do we have to be more diligent?
我们来读彼得后书一章第三节。
Let's read 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 3.
一章三节。
Verse 3.
神能已将一切关乎生命和敬虔的事赐给我们，皆因我们认识那用自己荣耀和美德招我们的主。
Verse 3, as his divine power has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness through the knowledge of him who called us by glory and virtue.
神的能力呢，已经有关将有关于生命跟敬虔的事情赏赐给我们了。
So God, through his divine power, has given to us all things that pertain to life and godliness.
其实我们大部分的人都是外邦人啊，跟神是隔绝的。
So most people are Gentiles and are separated from God.
我们本来跟神的国度是没有权、没有份、没有纪念的。
We originally had no part in the kingdom of God.
那主耶稣带福音来给我们。
But Lord Jesus brought the gospel to us.
那这个福音带来的就是生命的道。
And this gospel brought to us the word of life.
这个生命啊，你还记得有一个 年轻财主呢，来问主耶稣，我怎么样才可以得永生？
So if you remember, there was a rich young ruler who asked Lord Jesus, how do I gain eternal life?
所以神将这个生命的事赐给我们，其实这个生命跟那个永生原文是同一个字，就是我们今天神已经将永生的生命呢赏赐给我们了。
So in the original text, this word of life and this everlasting life, they are the same word. So God has given to us this word of everlasting life.
又说呢，父怎样在自己有生命，他就赐给子。也让他照样在自己有生命。
For as the Father has in himself a life in himself, so he has granted the Son to have life in himself.
又告应许我们呢，我们只要信耶稣行善的，到最后也会复活来得生命。
So it has been promised to us that if we believe in the Lord Jesus and we are doing good, then in the future we will also be resurrected.
所以当我们从洗礼上来，我们就有主耶稣基督的生命。
So when we rise from our baptism, water baptism, then we have Lord Jesus' life in us.
借着圣经，神又把这个敬虔的事情来教导我们。
And through the Bible, we are also taught the things pertaining to godliness.
那敬虔的奥秘是什么呢？
And what is this mystery of godliness?
就是神啊，在肉身显现。
And it is God appearing in flesh.
神呢被天使来肉身显现的耶稣呢被天使看见
，and Lord Jesus is seen by the angels in his fleshly body. And he is justified by the Holy Spirit.
又被传到外邦
，and this truth is spread to the Gentiles.
又被接到荣耀里面去
，and then he is received into glory.
那这些都是有关这个敬虔的奥秘啊。那所以其实这个敬虔的事情神给我们呢我们都没有什么努力我们就是白白的得到这些生命跟敬虔的事情
So these are all mysteries related to godliness So all of these things pertaining to life and godliness We did not work for them but we received freely
借着我们认识耶稣基督呢神就用他的荣耀跟美德召我们再把这个白白赐给我们
Through knowing Lord Jesus Christ, we have been given this by God who called us by glory and virtue.
那再来读第四节。
Let's keep reading verse 4.
他不只是将生命跟敬虔的事赐给我们了。
So not just giving to us the things pertaining to life and godliness.
第四节说，因此他又将又宝贵又极大的应许赐给我们，叫我们既脱离世上从情欲来的败坏，就得以神的性情有份。
Verse 4, by which have been given to us exceedingly great and precious promises, that through these you may be partakers of the divine nature, having escaped the corruption that is in the world through lust.
那我们还活在人间，那神又赐给我们一个极大、极宝贵的应许。
So while we are living in this world, God has given to us a great and precious promises.
就是让我们呢跟神的性情有份
，which is to be partakers of the divine nature of God。
神是圣洁的
，so God is holy。
当我们跟神的性情有份，就是神要让我们呢能够越来越像神一样。
When we are partakers of the divine nature of God, then we are becoming more and more like God。
我们都知道这是彼得在年纪在这个。晚年所写的一封书信。
We know that this book was a letter written by Elder Peter in his late in his life.
那你还记得主耶稣曾经跟他讲说呢？这个洗脚礼的道理，你现在不懂，你将来会明白。
And do you remember that Lord Jesus has once told Peter that you don't understand the teaching of the foot washing, but you will in the future.
但是如果我不洗你，你就与我无份。
But if I do not wash you, then you will have no part with me.
彼得在这边解释，到底洗脚礼跟主耶稣有份，那个份是在哪里呢？
So here, Peter is explaining this having a part with Lord Jesus. What does that mean?
就这里提到就是说，你会跟神的性情有份。
And here it teaches us that you may be partakers of the divine nature.
那我们带着肉体有时候还是被情欲所控制。
Because we have fleshly bodies, so we are oftentimes controlled by fleshly lust.
给你个应许，就是说，借着这个圣礼， 啊，借着将来的圣灵的力量，啊，你可以脱离罪跟死的律。
So we have been given this promise that through the power of God, we can escape from the corruption and death of sin.
到最后呢，你就有神的性情啊。
And then we will have the divine nature of God.
应许就是你一定会得到，虽然你现在不一定得到。
So the promise is that you will receive it, even though right now you may not have it yet.
所以虽然你在身份上已经圣洁了，虽然可是在行为上你可能还没有完完全全的跟神的完全的圣洁这个在行为上你还是有缺陷的。
So although by status, we are now sanctified, but in our behaviors, we are still lacking and we are not completely perfect like God.
但是这个应许呢，要让你跟脱离肉体的情欲跟神的性情有份，这个应许已经赐给我们了。
But this promise to be partakers of the divine nature and escape the corruption of lust, this promise has been given to us.
所以如果你殷勤的灵修，殷勤的照彼得长老的建议，那将来你肯定可以安然建筑。
So if we diligently cultivate, as Elder Peter encourages us, then in the future we will definitely be able to see God.
我们信主之后为什么还要更加殷勤呢？
Why do we have to be even more diligent after believing in God?
你有这个生命的这个你得到主耶稣基督的生命。
Now that you have received the life of Christ.
那你又有一个圣洁的应许。
And you have this promise of holiness.
所以呢，你继续努力，你一定会达到那个目标。
If you continue to work diligently, then you will surely reach this goal.
耶稣说，不是凡称呼我主啊主啊的人都可以进天国。
Lord Jesus said, not all who call me Lord, Lord will be able to enter the heavenly kingdom.
只有遵行天父旨意的人才可以进去。
Only those who follow the will of the heavenly Father will be able to enter.
将来要有许多人跟来求主说，哎，我们不是奉你的名赶鬼，奉你的名传福音吗？
In the future, there will be many who come to Lord Jesus saying, I preach and I cast out demons in your name.
可是耶稣会说，我不认识你们，你们这些作恶的人，离开我去吧。
But Lord Jesus will say, I do not know you, leave me.
如果你的小孩这个很努力读书，
if your child works hard in school,
SAT 也考得很好，
has a high SAT score,
但是没有收到哈佛大学的录取通知书，
but was not accepted by Harvard,
那你怎么样努力，怎么样旁听哈佛的学科，你还是没有办法从哈佛毕业。
No matter how hard you work or how much you audit Harvard courses, classes, you still won't be able to graduate from Harvard.
我们主耶稣为我们预备的国度比哈佛更美好。
And this heavenly kingdom that's prepared for us by the Lord is even better than Harvard.
他给你进去的这个录取通知书。
And he has given to us this acceptance letter to go in.
你还是要努力啊，你还是要努力，将来才可以毕业啊，才可以安然见主啊。
But you still have to work hard so that you can graduate in the future and see the Lord.
这个就是为什么我们要更殷勤的原因。
So this is why we have to be even more diligent.
那彼得长老跟我们讲，你要在七个方面更殷勤啊。
And Elder Peter tells us that we have to be more diligent in seven aspects.
我们来看彼得后书第一章的第一章的第五节前面。
Let's read 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 5.
后书一章五节，正因这缘故，你们要分外的殷勤，有了信心，要加上德性。
Verse 5, but also for this very reason, giving all diligence, add to your faith virtue.
所以你今天有生命是因为你有信心嘛，你因为相信，所以你受洗，有受洗你就有这个生命跟应许。
So today you have life because of your faith, because you believe, so you're baptized and then receive life in this promise.
可是呢，你还要再加上德性。
After this faith, you also have to add to it virtue.
那这个德性呢，就是这个原文同一个字，就是第三节的主用他的荣耀跟美德找我们。那个美德就是主的德性，美好的德性。
So this virtue is the same word as verse 3, where it says by glory and virtue.
那主耶稣的美德在哪里呢？
So what is the virtue of Lord Jesus?
我们都知道主耶稣啊，他柔和谦卑。
We know that Lord Jesus is gentle in spirit.
所以彼得也说呢,他被骂不还口,受威吓不说羞辱的话。
So that is why Peter also says that when he is rebuked, he does not speak back.
当父的旨意跟他的想法不一样的时候,他也愿意来照父的旨意来做。
And when his will is different from the will of the Father, he is still willing to follow the will of the Father.
一生充满了爱来爱人爱神。
So his life was filled with love to love others and also love God.
所以保罗说他是爱我为我舍己。
So Paul said that because he loves, so then he sacrificed himself.
所以这个十字架的大爱啊。 十字架一被高举呢，就有许多人被吸引来归向耶稣啊。So
because the cross is exalted, so many are attracted to follow Lord Jesus.
所以今天我们信耶稣，不只是相信，我们还要追求那种耶稣基督的美德，耶稣基督的芬芳。So
today, when we believe, we're not just believing, but we have to seek and strive for this virtue of Christ and this fragrance of Christ.
最近我们说芬芳是闻得到的啦，这个。 你可以从一个人的生命看到，他真的有耶稣基督的美德。So
fragrance is something that you can smell. So from a person's life, you can truly observe that they truly have the virtue of Christ.
如果您有在关心台湾的教会，那最近有一个台湾的陈建光传道过世，蒙主召回去了。
So if you follow the news in the church in Taiwan, then you would know that recently a preacher Chen in Taiwan passed away.
这个陈建光传道跟他太太，他们受差去泰国帮助那边的圣工。Preacher
Chen and his wife were sent to Thailand to help with the church work there.
那他们回来度假，需要这个住旅馆隔离。
So they came back to Taiwan for vacation and had to stay in a quarantine hotel.
突然那个所住的旅馆发生大火。
And there was a big fire in the hotel.
那个传道还录影，把那个消防车来的，还有他的一些想说话都录起来。
And the preacher even filmed the ambulance, the fire truck coming, and he spoke in the video as well.
想不到这个就是他最后的一个遗言呢。Yeah,
that those were his last words.
那传道娘感谢主，她主耶稣没有给她带走，同样在这个旅馆，主耶稣没有给她带走。So
thank God, the preacher's wife, Lord Jesus did not take her this time.
那最近有一个台湾总会有一个同工写的一篇文章了哈，然后提到呢，他打电话给这个传道娘。
And there's another worker in Taiwan who wrote an article, and he mentioned that he called the preacher's wife, and the preacher's wife told him.
他说这个都是神所命定的。
And she said, this was the timing of God.
他说，更何况我觉得我们去泰国是我们夫妻两个最同心同行的一个时光。
And she said, our trip to Thailand, I feel, was our the time of our lives when we were the most united in our hearts, in our mind.
你知道，因为很多人听到这个新闻呢，就希望能够拿金钱来资助他们。
So many members who heard this news wanted to help them financially.
可是他们说呢，他们家族不接受私下的见证慰问。
But the preacher's family said that they will not accept financial help privately.
所有的捐赠慰问金呢，由总会来统筹管理。So
all offerings and other forms of financial help will go through the GA.
如果有多余的，他们希望能够去帮助那些比他们更需要的人。And
any extra, they want to use it to help those who are more in need.
那这个写文章的这个同工呢，他就提到说，其实他们家里的唯一的经济支柱没有了，如果他们接受私下的捐赠也不为过了哈。
So this worker who was writing said that because they have lost their only source of financial means, so then it's only natural if they would be willing to receive help.
但是呢, 他们这样的做法, 你就看到他们那种单纯, 知足, 无私的, 啊, 那种, 那种美德啊。
But by doing so, you can really see the family's virtue of selflessness and contentment.
所以真的有的人读到这样的文章, 这样工人的家庭, 啊, 会掉眼泪的。
So many who read this sharing about the worker's family, they shed tears.
你就从他们的反应当中呢，闻到他们不只是有信心啊，他们还有耶稣基督的德性。
So from their response, you can smell that not only does this family have faith, they also have the virtue of Christ.
再来看彼得后书的一章第五节的下半段。
Let's continue reading 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 5, the second half.
这边提到有信心加上德性，有德性要加上知识。
Add to your faith virtue, to virtue knowledge.
那不只是追求德性，还要加上知识啊。
So not just seeking virtue, but also adding to it knowledge.
就像保罗对腓立比教会信徒这样讲。
And just like Paul said to the church in Philippi.
所以我祷告的就是你们的爱心，要在各样的知识跟见识上多而又多了。And
this I pray that your love may abound still more and more in knowledge and all discernment.
所以你不只是有爱心，但是你还有知识，因为呢。 你看哦，来到你们当中传福音的，有的是传错福音，有的是假先知。那你们一样用爱心对待，那这样子有时候是，有时候这个爱就失去它的价值。So
not just love, but also knowledge and discernment, because those who come and preach among you, some may be false teachers or preaching false gospels. So even if you treat them with love, without knowledge and discernment, this love is somewhat lost.
弟兄姐妹，我们还要追求属灵的知识的长进。
So brothers and sisters, we also have to diligently seek a growth in our spiritual knowledge.
知识其实是一种钥匙。
So knowledge is actually a key.
所以耶稣这样讲，你们法利赛人有祸了，因为你们把知识的钥匙夺去了，自己不进去呢，要进去的人，你们也阻挡他们。So
Lord Jesus once said, Woe to you Pharisees, for you have taken away the key of knowledge. You did not enter in yourselves, and those who were entering in you hindered.
因为你掌握钥匙呢，掌握知识就掌握那个珍宝的，掌握甚至永生的一个钥匙啊。
So when you have knowledge, then you have the key to this treasure and this key to eternal life.
其实知识也是一种力量。
So knowledge is a kind of power.
知识会告诉你你要做怎么样更正确的决定。
It will tell us how to make even more correct decisions.
所以我们殷勤就是你要对神的知识要更加的追求。
So we have to be diligent to seek the knowledge concerning spiritual
things.
Just like it is written in Hosea chapter 6.
说我们务要认识主，要竭力追求认识他。
It says, let us know, let us pursue the knowledge of the Lord.
那我们怎么样来真正来追求？就是像上个月的，这个成人神训班，这个就是一个 很好的机会，让我们在知识上更加的深入，更加的长进。
So how do we pursue the knowledge of the Lord? Just like last month's NATS, it was a great opportunity for us to grow in knowledge of God.
鼓励同龄们，一定要参加查经的聚会。
So I encourage everyone to participate in Bible study.
因为那是有系统的来认识神的话。
Because it is a systematic way to get to know the Word of God. So Timothy was able to become such a good worker because from childhood he knew the Holy Scriptures.
有时候我在教会看到一些年轻人，他们也是非常的 aggressively, 非常的努力的在认识神的话。
So sometimes I see in church some youth who are also aggressively pursuing the Word of God.
常常说，如果你一天读三章，一年就把它读完了。
And if you read three chapters in the Bible a day, then you can finish the whole Bible in a year.
年轻人呐、啊，那个一天读好几章啊。
And there was a youth who read multiple chapters a day.
后来他信主没有多久就当教会负责人。
And then not long after believing, this youth became a council member.
那所以真的有时候我们觉得在后的在前呐、啊，在前的在后。
So sometimes those who are last are first, and those who are first are last.
那我们再来看彼得后书的第二章啊，第一章第六节。
Let's keep reading 2 Peter chapter 1, verse 6.
要追求什么呢？
And what else should we pursue?
六节说，有了知识，又要加上节制。
Verse 6, to knowledge, self-control.
英文叫 self-control, 就是你有知识还要自我控制一下了哦。
So after knowledge, we also have to have self-control.
为什么知识还要自我控制呢？
So how come after knowledge, we have to add on to it self-control?
其实哦，这个学海无涯啦，这个知识哦。有时候很多你想要知道的，有时候不在圣经里面，你一定要去知道，到最后真的会落入试探当中。
Because we know that there is no limit to learning, so what you want to know, if it's not in the Bible and you want to seek out more resources outside the Bible, you may fall into temptation.
你看哦，保罗说哈，有现在我们哦，在认识神方面，好像看镜子啊，从镜子里面观看了、啊，是模糊不清的啦。
So Paul has once described that right now it's as if we are seeing in a mirror and it's dim and blurry.
到时候我们跟神面对面哈，我们就会全然知道，就如同主知道我们一样啊。
And in the future, when we can see God face to face, then we will know all just like God knows us.
所以有一些东西你一定要去知道，然后也教导人说这个肯定是这样，其实圣经没有。
So some things you just have to find out and you can teach others, this is the way, even though the Bible doesn't say so.
到最后我们就会落入了骄傲的试探。
Then in the end, we will fall into the temptation of pride.
因为其实哦，知识会叫人自高自大。
Because knowledge makes people prideful.
唯有爱心才能够造就人啊。
Only love can edify.
所以哦，圣经上跟我们说，隐秘的事是属于我们神的，明显的事是永远属于我们的。
So the Bible tells us the secret things belong to the Lord our God, and those things which are revealed belong to us.
啊，所以按照神要让我们知道的，我们来知道就好了。
So we just have to know according to what God wants us to know.
弟兄姐妹，神不像青蛙了，你可以把它拿来桌子上可以分析、可以解剖的。
So brothers and sisters, God is not like a frog, and we can put him on the table and dissect it.
神是不会被知识给限制住的。
God will not be restricted by knowledge.
神是在，就是你以为你已经知道了，其实很多东西我们还不认识他。
Even if you may think you know, but there's still many things about God that we cannot understand.
这人这样讲啊。
So someone has once said.
他说：“我的心不狂傲，我的眼不高大。”
My heart is not.Prideful and my eyes is not lofty.
重大和测不透的事呢，我也不敢去做。
What cannot be measured by the great rivers, I will not do either.
所以我们在学习方面一直要有一颗谦卑的心。
So in terms of learning, we have to have a humble heart.
那再来呢？有了节制，还要加上忍耐。
And then to self-control, perseverance.
我们来读一章的六节哈。
Let's read chapter 1 verse 6.
有了知识要加上节制，有了节制要加上忍耐。
To knowledge, self-control; to self-control, perseverance.
我们做一个好的基督徒啊，我们要追求另外一个就是忍耐。
So to be good Christians, something else we have to pursue is perseverance.
这个节制啊，是一种 self-control， 是一种自我控制的力量。
So self-control is this power, this ability to control oneself.
我们常常说哈，你两只手满满的，要把嘴巴控制起来，不说你好厉害哦，你有很多的资源哦，这个要很大的自制力啊。
So if your hands are full, if you need a lot of self-control to not speak with your mouth.
Yeah, 就是不要 boasting 啊，不要
to not boast with your mouth if your hands are full.
自夸，那这个就是需要你要忍耐啊，你要 你要有那个真的有一个耐性哈、哦、呀，是，我虽然拥有很多，但是我知道我的嘴巴要怎么处理，我要有耐性的。
So when you have a lot of possessions, in order to not boast for yourself, you have to have a lot of self-control and also a lot of patience and perseverance.
您可能听过这个好奇会害死一只猫啊。
You may have heard the saying, curiosity kills the cat.
我们很想了解更多，然后你就去 explore， 你就去冒险。到最后你像那只好奇的猫。
We really want to know more, so then we go exploring, and then in the end, we're like that cat.
就像底拿，雅各唯一的女儿啊，回到自己故乡，爸爸的故乡之后呢？
Just like Dina, Jacob's only daughter, and he went back to Jacob's homeland.
住在示剑这个地方，他就说、哦、我要出去看看那些外邦人，看看那里的女孩子。
And then she was dwelling in Shechem, and then she said, I want to go and see the other women, the Gentile women of this place.
她想要知道更多，如果她忍耐一下，也许找哥哥一块去。
So she wanted to see the daughters of the land and wanted to know more. If she had only been patient and persevered longer, maybe gotten one of her brothers to go with her.
她就不会发生被那个世界王子抓住她。violate her, 这个侮辱她的一些动作了。
Then she wouldn't have been violated by the prince of Shechem.
那这个是从负面的、哦、你这个姿势你要有一点节制，好像忍耐，好、哦、所以呢，你不会很冲动的这个好奇，那就害死人。
So this is a negative example, but it shows how with knowledge, we also have to have self-control and perseverance so that we won't be killed by our curiosity.
我们正面的例子，主耶稣也跟我们讲、哦、你有了这个知识，有了这个神的道、哦你要存在善良的心里面呢，然后继续忍耐来结果子。
There's also a positive example of Lord Jesus telling us that when the seed is on the good ground, you have to have perseverance and bear fruit.
我们结果子也要有一个耐性啊。
So to bear fruit, we have to have patience.
我们听道理，有时候你会觉得听这么多有什么用？反正、哦、我每次要去试，我都失败啊。
When we listen to the gospel, sometimes we may think, what is the use of listening to so much? When I try things that I always fail.
有时候呢，我很努力想要让自己变得更好，可是我心里愿意，可是我肉体行不出来啊。
Sometimes I really want to better myself, but although my heart, mind is willing, my flesh is not.
那主耶稣真的提醒我们，落在那个好土地里的，你要持守那个道理、哦、那个就好像人听得到，持守在诚实善良的心里面、哦、你要忍耐，要忍耐来结果子。
So Lord Jesus encourages us that he who receives the seed on the good ground has to persevere in a heart of goodness and kindness, and then you will indeed bear fruit.
我们常常说屡战屡败，可是有的人说呢，把它改一下，屡败屡战。你每一次打仗都失败，可是有人说你每一次失败都还要起来打仗。
So there is a Chinese saying that at every time you battle, and then you keep failing. But then someone also said you can change it up and say every time you fail, you can continue to battle.
我们靠着主，我们凡事都可以做，真的会有胜利。
Because by relying on God, we can do anything, and we will indeed be triumphant.
再看彼得后书一章的第六节。有了忍耐又要加上前进。
And then let's keep reading the last part of 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 6, to perseverance godliness.
那这个前进啊，翻前进，其实另外一些翻中文的就是前程，跟或者是翻成进前啊，我们还有一个追求前程的心啊。
So we must have a heart that pursues godliness.
哦，那这个进前需要操练。
And to have godliness, we must train ourselves.
身上讲操练身体还有益处，唯独操练敬虔呢，今生来生都有应许。
So the Bible tells us, for bodily exercise profits a little, but godliness is profitable for all things, having promise of the life that is now and of that which is to come.
那你怎么操练敬虔呢？
So how do we exercise our godliness?
我们要试着去控制我们的嘴巴。
We have to try to control our mouth.
所以要弃绝那些世俗的话。
We have to reject the worldly words.
那主耶稣一直谈到法利赛人有敬虔的外貌，没有敬虔的实意。
And Lord Jesus often talks about how the Pharisees, they have godly exterior, but not godly hearts.
所以我们追求敬虔，加上敬虔就是你要有敬虔的外貌，更要有敬虔的内心，实意。
So when we talk about pursuing godliness, we must have godly appearance, but also, more importantly, godly heart.
我可能跟你们讲过，每次我到非洲去，我小弟有机会去非洲的时候， 看到他们每个安息日，他们都把最好的那一套衣服穿来敬拜神。
So when I've had the chance to go to Africa in the past, every Sabbath day, the brothers and sisters there, they wear their best clothes on Sabbath.
真的，他们礼拜六一定把鞋子刷得干干净净的，刷得有时候会发亮。
And on Sabbath, they always shine their shoes to the point where it's really bright and shiny.
我那个鞋子，我说哇，我的鞋子跟你们比起来，我这个鞋子是。 你们都会发亮的,
So I've told them, my shoes compared to yours, yours are so much shinier.
真的，他们有一个敬虔的外貌，但是很多人都有敬虔的实意啊，敬虔的内在。
So that not only did they have godly appearances, but they all, most of them also had very godly hearts as well.
大家分享过，我们到杜拜去，那里是非洲来的弟兄。
We've also shared before about going to Dubai, and there are brothers there from Africa. They wake up every day at 5 to cultivate.
那我们去帮忙他们，我们就跟着他起来，然后就那一个小时就是读圣经、唱诗、祷告，就是这样。
So when we went to help in Dubai, we would wake up with them, and then for that 1 hour, we're just praying, reading the Bible, and singing hymns.
我常常想为什么神爱他们，因为他们真的很虔诚。
So I often think about why God loves them so much, and it's because they are truly very godly.
那我们再来看，我们还要再追求，最后就是要追求爱。
And finally, it tells us we have to pursue love.
爱是我们的终极追求。And
love is our ultimate pursuit.
所以第七节说，有了敬虔，又要加上爱弟兄的心；有了爱弟兄的心，又要加上爱众人的心。以弗所书1章第7节。
2 Peter chapter 1, verse 7, to godliness, brotherly kindness, and to brotherly kindness, love.
我们刚说这是我们最主要的、最终极的追求。
So, like I've just mentioned, this is our main and ultimate pursuit.
因为神就是爱。
Because God is love.
Yeah. 有的人找神找不到神。
Some people can't find God.
但是在爱里面他们找到神。They
found God in love.
希斯摩先生他写了一首诗啊。There's
a Chinese poet who wrote this poem.
他说：“我攀登万仞的高冈，荆棘杂乱的我的衣裳。”He
said, "I climb to the highest mountains, and the thorns are in my clothes, tore my clothes."
向缥缈的云外望，他说：“上帝，我望不见你。”
And I look out onto the lofty clouds, and I say, Lord, I cannot see you.
他说，我向坚厚的地壳里掏，捣毁了龙蛇们的老巢。And
he said, I dig into the hard earth and into the nest of snakes, serpents.
那在无底的沼潭里，我叫上帝。
In the deep swamp, I also yell, God,
我听不到你,
I cannot hear you.
我在路旁见一个小孩,
and then I see a child by the wayside.
活泼秀丽, 衣裳褴褛,
and he is lively and adorable, but his clothes are tattered.
他叫声妈, 眼睛亮着爱。
And he called mother, mom, and he had love in his eyes.
他说：“上帝，他眼里有你呀。”And
God, in this child's eyes, there is you. You are.
真的，我们有时候凭着眼睛、凭着耳朵，我们找不到神。So
sometimes, just by our eyes or our ears, we cannot find God.
但是在那个妈妈 叫啊女儿小小女孩叫妈妈的眼神里面呢，我们看到爱，我们在爱里面看到神。
But when this young child is calling out to her mom, we can see in her eyes God.
爱真的是从神来啊。
Because love is from God.
所以我们最后一定要跟神一样，一定要追求爱啊。
So finally, we must be like God and pursue love.
那爱不只是爱自己的弟兄呢，最后还要爱众人呢。
And love is not just for our brothers, but also for all.
这个爱众人，我觉得最重要就是把福音传给众人。
And the most important thing about loving all is to preach the gospel to all.
在美国现在有一个这个 Spanish ministry 啊，就是有关英文方面的一个事工。
So there is a Spanish ministry in the U.S.
感谢神，最近有个阿根廷的慕道朋友先跑到我们美国这个Spanish 的 ministry， 这个就是这个慕道朋友先跑找到我们在美国做的这个。西班牙文的宣道工作的人呢、
So thank God, there's this Argentinian truth seeker who found our Spanish ministry.
那这些同工们牧养他之后呢，我们也请他到阿根廷的真耶稣教会去。
And our workers pastored this truth seeker, and we also told them they can go to our church in Argentina.
感谢神，他这样现在也得到圣灵哦。
And thank God this truth seeker has received the Holy Spirit.
我们一定要把福音传给万邦，这个是爱众人最积极，最好的一个做法。
We must spread the gospel to all nations. This is the best and most proactive way to love all.
好，以上我们谈到殷勤啊，要在哪几方面殷勤啊。
So we've mentioned in what aspects we have to be more diligent.
那这个好处是什么？它就是如果你这样做，你就可以结果子。
And what is the benefit of this? It is to bear fruit.
那你也不会失脚，永不失脚啊。
And we will also not stumble.
好，我们来读彼得后书的第一章的第八节。
Let's read 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 8.
你们如果充充足足的有这样。就必使你们在认识我们的主耶稣基督上，不至于闲懒不结果子了。
Verse 8, for if these things are yours and abound, you will be neither barren nor unfruitful in the knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
所以呢，你以上都做了，你就不会说你这个懒惰不结果子了，你就会结果子了。
So if you have done all of these things above, then you will be neither barren nor unfruitful, meaning that you will be
对主耶稣基督的认识更加深入了。
And you will have a deeper knowledge of our Lord Jesus Christ.
弟兄姐妹，我们都记得是使徒约翰这样讲哦。看啊，斧头已经放在树根上了，凡不结果子砍下来，丢在火里焚烧。
So John the Baptist has said, now the axe is laid to the root of the trees, therefore every tree which does not bear good fruit is cut down and thrown into the fire.
你也记得主耶稣讲一个比喻。
And we also remember that Lord Jesus has said a parable.
有一棵无花果树栽种在葡萄园里面。
That there was a fig tree planted in a vineyard.
一个非常容易看到的，甚至可以说比较卑贱的，种在一个葡萄园是指着比较丰富的，比较高贵的一个园子。所以我们好像这个无花果树被种在葡萄园里面。
So this is a more common and lowly type of tree, the fig tree, and it's planted in the vineyard, which is more superior. So we are like the fig tree planted in a vineyard.
是主人来的时候呢，这么好的照顾，却找不到果子。
And when the keeper came, he has taken good care of the tree, but there was no fruit.
他说：“看啊，我这三年来到这无花果树面前哦，竟然都找不到，把它砍了吧。”
So he said, "Look, for 3 years I have come seeking fruit on this fig tree and found none. So cut it down."
为什么要让它白占土地呢？
Why does it use up the ground?
所以哦，今天我们的主耶稣，我们主耶稣啊，这么的爱我们呢，拣选我们哦，他期待我们呢。能够来做光做盐，来有许多属灵的德性。
So today, Lord Jesus loves us so much and has chosen us. He wants us to be the salt and the light of this world and have these spiritual virtues.
请问您有没有结果子呢
？So have you bear fruit?
或者是您白占地土呢
？Or are you just taking up ground?
小弟大概四月就开始种，在后面做验种这个四季，这个叫四季豆吗？这个叫什么豆？在种一些豆子。
So from April, I've been planting green beans in my backyard.
奇怪了，那个本来很多收成的，怎么现在是热了吗？就开始不结果子了。
Oddly enough, originally there was much harvest, but now maybe because of the heat, it's not bearing fruit.
那我就想，我天天浇水，天天照顾它，你又不给我结果子，你再不给我结果子，我就要把你拔掉。
So I think I water you every day. I take good care of you, but you're not bearing any fruit. If you're still barren, then I'm going to dig you up.
我就想我有这个心哦，神真的，我们就像这个四季豆啊，神照顾我们，那也期待我们结果子。
So I have reflected that God truly has this kind of mindset too, that He has truly taken care of us, and wants us to bear fruit.
所以呢，我们一定要来殷勤哈。
So we must be more diligent in order to bear fruit.
我们来读第十节十一节，彼得后书一章十节十一节。
Let's read 2 Peter chapter 1 verse 10 and 11.
所以弟兄们应当更加殷勤，使你们所蒙的恩召和拣选坚定不移。你们若这样行，你们若行这几样，就永不失脚。这样就叫你们丰丰富富的得以进入我们主。
Verse 10, therefore, brethren, be even more diligent to make your call and election sure. For if you do these things, you will never stumble. 11, for so an entrance will be supplied to you abundantly into the everlasting kingdom of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ.
彼得长老非常有信心啊，非常肯定啊，你如果这几样多做了，就永不失脚。
So Elder Peter was very confident and assured that if you do these things, you will never stumble.
你在这个蒙的恩召跟神的拣选上面呢，你会坚定不移啦，坚定不会摇动。
You will make your call and election sure, so you will be steadfast and unwavering.
我们就可以进入神为我们设立永远的国度。
And then we will be able to enter into the everlasting kingdom that our God has prepared for us.
其实很多人因为没有在追求，信仰是空的。
So many people, because they are not pursuing, so their faith is empty.
基督徒有时候只是挂名，不是实在的。
So Christians, sometimes they are only by name, but not in substance.
有时候你把你这个 NYTS 或是学生灵会的照片拿起来看一看。
Sometimes if you look at your pictures from NYTS or Student Spiritual Convocation,
你知道，哇，这个不来了，那个不来了，这个离道了，那个换监营了。
You will realize that, some of these people have left the church, they no longer come, they have left the truth, or they have committed mortal sin.
那你就想，哎，这些人过去也跟我一起进食的。
And you would think, but these people, they once fasted with me in the past.
也看过异象的。
And some of these people have even seen visions.
为什么现在留不住了呢？
But how come they're unable to stay now?
常常因为我们没有更努力的，更殷勤的来追求神。
And oftentimes it's because we are not even more diligently seeking God.
所以弟兄姐妹们，我们不是一次得救，永远得救哦。
So brothers and sisters, it is not if we once are saved and then we will be saved.
不是你这个一信主了，现在就可以轻松反正我已经得到天国的许可证了。
It is not once you believe in the Lord, then you're free and will definitely be able to get into heaven.
我们要更殷勤。
Rather, we have to be even more diligent.
在信仰的追求上面加油。
And we have to work hard in our pursuit in our faith.
我们晚上就彼此见面，这样子。
So this concludes our evening's mutual encouragement.